Hello and welcome. Today we are beginning a new chapter in algebra. This chapter is chapter 5, which is called probability, and this is our first learning session. Okay, so our objective for today is going to be that students will be able to state the number of possibilities of an event. Okay, what's an event? Event is basically an action jiske alag alag outcomes ho sakte. For example, tossing a coin, that's an experiment I'm doing. Okay, I'm doing an action एंड उसके अलग अलग आउटकम्स हो सकते हैं, राइट? सो गेटिंग हेड्स इज वन आउटकम, गेटिंग टेल्स इज अनदर आउटकम. सो दीज आर इवेंट्स. सो कोई भी एक्शन हो रहा है या फिर कोई भी एक्सपेरिमेंट हो रहा है, देन यू शुड बी एबल टू टेल द नंबर ऑफ पॉसिबिलिटीज ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर एक्शन और इवेंट. ओके, सो दैट्स आवर ऑब्जेक्टिव फॉर टूडे. बट बिफोर वी एक्चुअली स्टार्ट सीइंग डिफरेंट डिफरेंट टर्म्स, स्टार्ट सॉल्विंग प्रॉब्लम्स in this particular chapter and start solving the practice set, I first wanted to discuss why are we learning probability in the first place. Okay, so let us take the example of the pandemic right now. There's a pandemic going on. So a question I would ask you is, there is this vitamin tablet. Okay, there is this vitamin tablet, and if you take that vitamin tablet, nothing great is going to happen to you. Life is going to go on as it is, but 1 out of 100 times you're going to die because of taking that tablet. I'm going to repeat that. Ek tablet hai, it's a vitamin tablet. If you take that vitamin tablet, it's a little better for your health, but nothing drastically is going to change for your body. Okay, but 1 out of 100 times, whenever you take that tablet, you will die. Will you take that tablet? Think about it. I think most of you will say, no, I will not take the tablet, right? अगर वो tablet ले जाए तो उससे बहुत ज्यादा फर्क नहीं पड़ रहा है, और 1 out of 100 chances भी है कि उससे मर सकते हैं हम लोग. So it does not make sense to take that tablet. But the similar is the case for coronavirus, isn't it? If you get coronavirus, out of the 100 people who get coronavirus, 1% of them are dying, which means out of every 100 people, 1% is dying out of coronavirus, right? So if you knew this, if you know that number, will you want to get coronavirus? No, right? But does that mean you're not going out? Does that mean you're washing your hands on time every time you go out? Does that mean you're practicing social distancing? Does that mean you do not take out your mask whenever you're trying to speak or whenever you're outside home? I don't think you all are doing that, right? Why is that? Because you haven't understood the concept of probability very well. If you won't take that tablet, क्योंकि उसमें 1 out of 100 chances है कि तुम उसमें मर सकते हो, तो तुम लोग को pandemic में बिना किसी reason के बाहर भी नहीं जाना चाहिए. तुम लोग को mask हमेशा अच्छे से लगा के रखना चाहिए, बार बार हाथ को धोना या sanitize करना चाहिए, और social distancing maintain करना चाहिए. But you're not maintaining. Why? Because you haven't conceptually understood कि दोनों के probability same हो, tablet लेने के और coronavirus होने के. Okay. If that's not convincing enough, assume कि अगर तुम लोग ने वो tablet ले लिया, तुमको कुछ नहीं होगा. Okay. तुम्हें कुछ भी नहीं होगा, तुम लोग अगर टैबलेट ले रहे हो तुम्हें कुछ भी नहीं होगा, बट 1 out of 100 चांस दैट वन ऑफ योर पेरेंट्स इज गोइंग टू गेट वेरी इल, दैट्स आल्सो वेरी सिमिलर टू आवर पैंडेमिक सिचुएशन, राइट? यंग लोगों को जनरली प्रॉब्लम नहीं हो रहा है इस वायरस से, बट जो ओल्डर पीपल है उनको प्रॉब्लम हो रहा है इस वायरस से. सो अगर तुम्हें पता था कि वो टैबलेट लेने से 1 out of 100 चांस है कि तुम्हारे पेरेंट्स बहुत ज्यादा सिक हो सकते हैं, विल यू टेक दैट टैबलेट? द आंसर विल बी नो. But the same probability is with coronavirus, isn't it? But even then, people are not following social distancing norm, not wearing masks and going out without any reason. So if you learn probability very well and you are able to give correct numbers to various events, ki acha iska ye probability, uska wo probability, kaun sa zyada hai, kaun sa kam hai, it is much easier for you to make decisions. Okay, so why do we learn probability? To make better decisions, to make informed decisions. You have numbers in front of you, and according to that, you will make decisions. For example, another example could be, which college should you choose after your 10th standard? So if I choose this particular college, my probability of getting, the probability of achieving my goal is this much. If I go to that college, my probability of achieving my goal is that much. Now you can compare, right? And you can take an informed decision which college you can go to. So that's the benefit of learning probability. Okay, making informed choices and taking good decision based on numbers. Okay, let us move ahead. So to be honest, probability is nothing new to us. Okay, we already use probability in our daily lives. So whenever we use these following words, we are using probability without even knowing about it. Okay, so when we use words like probable, maybe, impossible, sure, nearly, 50-50. So whenever we are using these words, we are using the concept of probability. So we are already using it in our language. Examples are here in these lines. Okay, most probably the rain will start from today. Most probably any काफी हाई प्रोबेबिलिटी है, 60% 70%. इन्फ्लेशन इज लाइकली टू राइज, यानी इट्स मोर देन 50%, राइट? लाइकली टू राइज यानी शायद, आई मीन होने के चांसेस ज्यादा, यानी 50% से ज्यादा लग रहा है. इट इज इम्पॉसिबल टू डिफीट इंडियन क्रिकेट टीम इन द नेक्स्ट मैच. इम्पॉसिबल यानी 100% इंडियन टीम ही जीतेगी, 100 out of 100. आई विल श्योरली गेट फर्स्ट क्लास. सो काफी ज्यादा कॉन्फिडेंट लग रहा है ना ये, जो जो कोई भी पर्सन ये बोल रहा है, आई विल श्योरली गेट फर्स्ट क्लास, विच मीन्स द पर्सन इज वेरी कॉन्फिडेंट. सो मे बी 90% चांसेस दैट दैट पर्सन इज गोइंग टू गेट फर्स्ट क्लास इन हिज और हर टेस्ट. नेक्स्ट, देयर इज नो पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ पोलियो इन्फेक्शन इफ अ चाइल्ड गेट्स इफ अ चाइल्ड इज गिवन द पोलियो वैक्सीन इन टाइम. नो पॉसिबिलिटी यानी जीरो प्रोबेबिलिटी. अगर टाइम पे पोलियो का वैक्सीन ले लिया सो पोलियो इन्फेक्शन होने का जीरो प्रोबेबिलिटी है, राइट? So we are already using the words related to probability in our daily life. In this chapter, what we're going to do is we're going to give numbers to each and every those words, each and every of these words. Okay, when I say surely, kitna sure? 60% sure or 90% sure? Okay, or if I say likely, then kitna likely? 30% likely, 90% likely? So we'll try to give numbers, and once we have numbers, now it's very easy to compare numbers, right? It's not easy to compare words like likely and sure. Likely ज़्यादा strong word है, sure ज़्यादा strong word है. It's difficult to compare, and it will change from person to person. But if I say inflation rise का chance है 70%, and यहाँ पे लिखा है कि I will 90% get first class. You know that 90% is more sure, and 70% 60% is less sure, isn't it? So once you get numbers, then it's more easy to make decision by comparing the numbers. Okay? So before we actually start solving the practice sets, we need to know what is the meaning of random experiments. Okay. So random experiments ke liye you have three conditions which need to be met. So the experiment in which all possible results are known in advance. Kya kya us experiments ke results ho sakte hai, sare ke sare pehle se hi pata hai. For example, if I say my experiment is tossing a coin. If my experiment is tossing a coin, उसके क्या क्या रिजल्ट हो सकते हैं? There are only two results. One is either I will get heads or I will get tails. Some of you all might say that it could actually stand vertically, right? So that could be a third result. Okay, so maximum two or three results. So we know what all are the results in advance. So that's the first condition. Second, but none of them can be predicted. So when you actually toss a coin, you don't know whether it will be a heads or a tails, right? So you cannot predict. So that's the second condition of a random experiment. And third is, there is equal possibility for each result. Okay, heads आने का भी equal chance है, tails आने का भी equal chance है, right? So सारे results आने का equal chance. So that's the third condition. First condition is all possible results are known in advance. क्या क्या outcomes हो सकते तुम्हें already पता है. Second is predict नहीं कर सकते तुम क्या result आने वाला है. Third is जो कुछ भी अलग अलग outcomes है सबके आने की possibility equal है. हेड्स भी आने का सेम पॉसिबिलिटी है, टेल्स भी आने का सेम पॉसिबिलिटी है. ओके, सो दैट्स द डेफिनेशन ऑफ रैंडम एक्सपेरिमेंट्स. एंड वी आर ओनली गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट रैंडम एक्सपेरिमेंट्स इन दीज चैप्टर्स. देर आर ऑल्सो एक्सपेरिमेंट्स विच आर नॉट रैंडम. एंड इफ यू हैव टू फाइंड प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ एक्सपेरिमेंट्स विच आर नॉट रैंडम, इट्स मोर डिफिकल्ट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, कल स्टॉक मार्केट ऊपर जाएगा या नीचे जाएगा, इट्स नॉट अ रैंडम एक्सपेरिमेंट, बिकॉज you don't know all the possible outcomes. Okay, and even if you know all the possible outcomes, sabka possibility equal nahi hai. Possibility is also governed by, for example, India or China ka kya relation chal raha hai, ya phir government ne koi naya policy nikala hai kya business ke liye. So all these factors play. So it's the probability of it going up and going down is not equal, right? So that's why calculating the probability for stock market is not easy. And उसके ऊपर पूरा का पूरा करियर बना देते हैं लोग कि स्टॉक मार्केट को प्रिडिक्ट कैसे करें. सो वी इन दिस चैप्टर इन योर 10th ग्रेड वी ओनली गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट रैंडम एक्सपेरिमेंट्स. ओके, सो फ्यू एग्जांपल्स ऑफ रैंडम एक्सपेरिमेंट्स आर टॉसिंग अ कॉइन, आई हैड एक्सप्लेन्ड योर, थ्रोइंग अ डाई. सो तुम लोग अगर सांप सीढ़ी खेलते हो, लूडो खेलते हो, तो उसमें जो डाइस होता है उसमें छह नंबर होते हैं, 1 2 3 4 5 6. व्हेनेवर यू थ्रो दैट डाइस, इट इज अ रैंडम एक्सपेरिमेंट, क्योंकि 1 आने का, 2 आने का, 3 4 5 6 सब नंबर्स आने का possibility equal. Okay. Next, picking a card from a set of cards bearing numbers 1 to 50. If I make 50 cards and I write numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, so on and so forth till 50. And I put them upside down and then I am asked to pick any one card from that. So, main kaun sa card choose karunga? Sabka equal possibility hai. So, again, that's a random experiment. Picking card from a pack of well-shuffled playing cards. Playing cards bhi also, you know what are the different cards. So, you know all the possible results. You cannot predict ki koi kaun sa card uthane wala hai. So, cannot predict. And possibility of each and every card being taken is equal. Koi bhi card le sakte hai, right? So, sab cards ko pick karne ka possibility equal hai. So, all these are examples of random experiment. And we are only going to deal with random experiments in this particular chapter. Okay. With that, I think we can now start solving practice set 5.1. So, the question says, how many possibilities are there in each of the following? So, first, Vanita. Vanita knows the following sites in Maharashtra. She is planning to visit one of them in her summer vacations. Okay. And what are the sites? Again, I'm not going to read out the sites. Okay, this is the first site. This is the second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth. Okay, so there are eight sites. So, Vanita has chosen eight sites and she wants to visit one of those sites for her summer vacation. So, how many possibilities are there in each of the following? So, first one, mein kitne possibilities honge? Because there are eight sites, right? Okay, eight sites hai and Vanita can go anywhere. So, the answer to the first question will be, there are eight sites of Maharashtra given. There are eight possibilities. So your answer is eight. Okay, eight possibilities in a random experiment of visiting a site out of these eight sites in Maharashtra. Agar you are conducting a random experiment, again, you all know the meaning of random experiment now. What are the three conditions? All possibilities should be known. Tumhe sare ke sare eight sites pata hai, to tumhe sare possibilities pata hai. Prediction nahi ho sakta. So you cannot predict Vanita kaun sa choose karne wali hai. And last is, no site is more likely. Possibility of choosing each and every site is equal. Okay. So, agar ye teen condition satisfy hui aur usko choose karna ek random experiment hai, then kitne possibilities hue? Eight possibilities. Okay. That's answer number one. So, I think now you all have got the idea how to find the number of possibilities. So, now try to solve the second one by yourself. Any day of the week is to be selected randomly. Any day of the week has to be selected randomly. How many possibilities will be there? I'll wait for 5 seconds for you to think, okay, and write the answer. Okay, so how many days are there in a week? There are 7 days, right? And any one day has to be picked randomly. So how many possibilities? There are 7 possibilities. So this is how you write the answer, okay? There are 7 days in a week. So first reason de do, and then the final answer. There are 7 possibilities in a random experiment of selecting a day of the week, okay? It has to be a random experiment. And that has to come in your answer also. Again, now try the third one by yourself. I'll wait for 5 seconds. You all can pause the video and write the answer by yourself and then check your answers. Okay. So I'm waiting 5 seconds for you to pause the video and write down the answer in your notebook. Okay. I hope you all have written the answer by now in your notebooks. Now check the answer if it's matching with what I have written here. So, select one card from a pack of 52 cards. If there are 52 cards and you have to select one card out of the 52 cards, the answer is going to be 52. Very simple, right? There are 52 cards in the pack. Therefore, there are 52 possibilities in a random experiment of selecting one card from the pack of 52 cards. Just make sure if you are able to write the sentence correctly. Is your sentence formation correct? Tumhare sentence mein 52 possibilities ye word aaya kya? Random experiment ye word aaya kya? Selecting one card from a pack of 52 cards aaya kya? Just check that if that all that has come in your answer. Okay. Last question is a little tricky question. Okay. It's not that easy. So, dikhne mein bahut easy lagta hai, but it's a little difficult. Okay. Let's see how many of you get that right. Again, I'm going to wait for 5 seconds. You pause the video here and write the answer to the fourth question by yourself. Okay. Fourth question is the last question. So I'll wait for 5 seconds. Okay, 5 seconds are up. I hope you have written the answer. So, one number from 10 to 20 is written on each card. Okay, so the question is cards total kitne hai? So, 20 minus 10 kitne ho gaye? 10 cards ho gaye, right? So, most students will write 10 cards, but that's not the correct answer. Why? Let us count. Okay, tumne chote chote pieces bana liye cards ke and you started writing. So, first card you will write 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 16, 17, 18, 19, 10 हो गए एंड द 11th वन इज 20. इफ यू कैन काउंट इट यू कैन सी टोटल नंबर ऑफ पेजेस विल बी टोटल नंबर ऑफ कार्ड्स विल बी 11 एंड नॉट 10. बहुत लोग 10 माइनस 20 कर देते हैं, दे राइट इट 10, राइट द आंसर इज 10 पॉसिबिलिटीज, बट यहाँ 10 से लेके 20 तक है. So in total you have 11 cards and you can count that on your fingers. Okay, so you have total 11 cards. So your answer will be there are 11 cards numbered from 10 to 20. Hence there are 11 possibilities in a random experiment of selecting whatever. You can just copy that from the question. Okay, so that was your practice set 5.1. I hope you have understood this and you all can write the possibilities by yourself for different events or different random experiments which are given to you. Okay. So let us quickly revise. First we discuss why you should study probability. You should study probability because then you will get numbers which you can compare easily and take better decisions for your life. Next, we use the language of probability. Every day we had seen examples of that, and then we had seen what is the meaning of random experiments. It should satisfy three conditions. All outcomes should be known, then you should not be able to predict, and all the outcomes have equal possibility. That's the definition of random experiment. And then we had seen how do you find the number of possibilities of given event. Us events ke kitne outcomes hai ye dekh lo, and that will be your number of possibilities. Okay. So just check if you have achieved today's learning objective. Can you state the number of possibilities given an event? If the answer is yes, then you have achieved the today's learning objective. If the answer is no, then maybe you need some more practice. Maybe you need to watch the video again. Okay. So that's it for this learning session. Probability, this chapter is very easy. If you see, you've already completed the first practice set in the first video itself. So it's a small chapter. It's a very simple chapter. And it's also very scoring. So agar probability pe koi chapter aata, probability mein koi question aata hai board exam mein, you should always attempt that because probability ke questions are generally very easy to solve. So make sure you're practicing this particular chapter very well so that you can score very good marks in this particular chapter in board exam. Okay. So that's it for this learning session. I hope you all understood and had fun. I hope you all see me in the next learning session. Till then, see you guys. Bye and peace.